Yeah, I could take a little thirst.
And one guy in particular showed some thirst, Mr. Lil Wayne. How did that feel?
It was good. It just shows that our sport can entertain any demographic. And like I said, I don't care why they watch, as long as they watch it. And it was great. You know, he showed not only love to me, myself, my team, my school. You know, he watched women basketball. He's a huge fan of my craft, and likewise with me, with him.
Now, what does the future hold for Miss Skylar Diggins?
Hopefully to pursue a career in basketball. You know, I want to go to the WNBA, definitely. But right now, I'm getting my degree in business management at the Mendoza College of Business, which is the number one undergrad business program, and I'm excited to see where that takes me. I've started an internship with ESPN next week, so trying to get into that, you know, get my foot in that aspect of it and have a plan B.
All right, now we're not used to seeing you outside of the basketball shorts. What are you wearing today?
You know what, I'm a college student. You know what, my mom.
A lot of traveling, games, you know, back-to-back at times, and just living that the in-season life. You know, I'm pretty boring. I really don't do much, kind of live for practice. And, you know, just trying to get ready for these games and keep getting better every day. I'm not at all. I think in college, maybe you could say that. But coming into the WNBA, you have so many great players in this league, great veterans who have paved the way, like, for players, you know, paved the way for players like. But I hope I will be. You know, but I want to earn mine now, just giving credit to the veterans who've done so much for this league and so much for me as a player coming up watching them play. And it came down for me to Stanford and Notre Dame. I was either going to go really far or I was going to stay right in my backyard. And I had the perfect university right in my backyard. Fortunately, I was lucky enough to grow up with a program like Notre Dame and a great coach like Coach Buffett McGraw and that coaching staff. They were just awesome. So I was great to have them in my backyard, and just a great academic institution and a program that really developed me as a player.
Now you signed, you're the first lady of Rock Nation Sports.
My kitchen is it's not broken in too much, I'm just going to say that. But I have a few little meals I can prepare and stuff like that. I picked up the piano, I play a little bit of piano. Love to listen to music and things like that. But other than that, I don't do much but play ball outside of that, and got into some TV, love reality TV and stuff like that. So, that's what it is for me.
So what's it like gelling with your teammates? I noticed that now you guys kind of struggled a little bit in the beginning, but you guys gelled together. You went through that. You started picking up some wins. What has that experience been like for you to gel with your teammates like Candace Wiggins, Liz Cambage, and those ladies?
Yeah, well, we have a great group of girls. We get along so well off the court. Just such a tight-knit group. And it's great having players like Liz and who's just a phenomenal player to play with, and Candace, who I've known for years and is one of my really good friends, who's a vet and a world champion to learn from. So I love the group of girls here. I think it's fun every time I
rocking our day in the town.
Figuring out something we're doing wrong every game, and that's always good to understand what's the problem, what do you need to work on. It's kind of been different for us every game. We fix one problem, we need work on some other things. But I mean, it's a process, we understand that, and we're just trying to keep pushing. We can't hang our heads, we have to stay positive and not get used to this losing thing. You know, we have to keep pushing each other to get better and hold ourselves accountable for the mistakes that we make.
Thank you. Does each game serve as a learning experience?
I'll say.
And if so, what are you learning?
Well, I think when you watch the film and things like that, you learn the mistakes that you make. And, you know, we have very good players on our team. We have very good players on our team. We have very good individuals. We just have to find a way to gel. We have great defensive players and we have great offensive players. And we got to gel and find that chemistry on both ends. And that's what you kind of see on film as far as learning experience. You see what you're doing wrong and things that you can do better. And you try to fix that for next game.
Your comfort level out there? Just another game is no different other than, you know, being paid?
I mean, I don't know how to answer that, really. I mean, it's basketball still. Obviously, it's the next level. Everybody's good. So just working on the things I need to do to help our team out and make it easier on my teammates.
Scott. Yeah, and it's not about the first game that she plays with the Tulsa Shock. It's going to be the first time she's on the practice floor with her teammates. This is a player who demands excellent
job as a point guard and come in and do whatever the team needs me to do and try to be that floor general and the leader. And so many great opportunities with the rule changes this year, defensive 3 seconds, the three-point line move back it'll give me a lot of opportunity to work with a lot of space and kind of use the pick and roll, which is my bread and butter. You've had Dame and South Bend are the best fans. They have the best fan base in the nation. I know they'll support me anywhere that I go, and so will my parents. And I'm just excited about this. I want to be the best in my work ethic, and I hope I can bring that down to Tulsa and do whatever Coach Klopp needs me to do.
Coach Klopp, she's already very familiar. Thank you.
Thanks.